Cloud engineering is one of the most in-demand and high-paying professions in the information technology space and will be for years to come as more and more businesses are replacing their infrastructure with cloud services. Hi, I'm Simon. I've been in IT for over 10 years. And in this video, I will show you the steps I would take if I were to start a career as a cloud engineer. The video is split into 7 steps. Make sure not to skip them because they are all equally important. By the end of this video, you will have a clear path to becoming a successful cloud engineer. I will regularly sprinkle in some valuable resources and where to find them, so you might want to stick around for a while. Let's go! Before we explore how to become a cloud engineer, you should first hold your breath for a minute and assess where you're coming from and where you want to go. Many cloud engineers I know have a systems administrator IT infrastructure background. And with more businesses shifting their workloads from self-run data centers to the cloud, the transition to cloud engineering often happens quite naturally. This also means that cloud engineering is pretty different from, let's say, web development. But we'll come back to this later. For now, let's see what the cloud engineer role is all about. On a high level, a cloud engineer is responsible for designing, building, and maintaining an organization's cloud computing infrastructure and systems. This includes implementing and managing cloud-based solutions, such as virtual servers, storage systems, and networking configurations, ensuring that the organization's cloud infrastructure is scalable, reliable, and secure, monitoring the performance of cloud systems and identifying opportunities for optimization, automating the deployment and management of cloud resources using tools such as scripts, APIs, and configuration management systems, collaborating with developers and other IT professionals to design and implement cloud-based solutions for specific business needs. No worries, we'll cover each point in detail in the next part. Becoming a cloud engineer means acquiring new skills and building upon existing ones, depending on whether you already have a related background. If I could give you only one piece of advice, it's this: don't skip the fundamentals. Many aspiring engineers struggle with the most basic yet frequently required concepts. As a cloud engineer, it is essential to have a strong foundation in the following areas. General cloud computing concepts. This includes understanding the different types of cloud services. For example, infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service, as well as the benefits and drawbacks of using cloud services. Networking. A cloud engineer should have a good understanding of networking concepts such as IP addressing and subnetting. You need to understand how IP addresses are structured and how they are used to identify devices on a network. Network protocols. Knowledge of standard network protocols such as TCP, UDP, HTTP, and HTTPS is essential. DNS. Knowing how the domain name system works and how it is used to resolve domain names to IP addresses is important for accessing resources on the internet. Network security. Understand concepts such as firewalls, VPNs, and encryption and how they can be used to secure networks. Network monitoring. Know how to monitor and troubleshoot networks using tools such as ping, traceroute, and network analyzers. Operating systems. Familiarity with Windows and especially Linux is important for a cloud engineer as they are commonly used in cloud environments. Virtualization. It is essential to understand the concepts of virtualization and its use in the cloud. For example, there are different types of virtualization, such as hardware virtualization, application virtualization, and desktop virtualization. A cloud engineer should know these different types and how they work. Security. Ensuring the security of cloud environments is a critical responsibility of a cloud engineer. This includes understanding security protocols and best practices for securing cloud resources. You might have witnessed the rise of ransomware attacks and corporate hacks over the last few years, so creating and maintaining secure services and infrastructure has become even more critical. A As a cloud engineer, it is beneficial to have experience with multiple cloud providers, as different organizations and industries may use different providers based on their specific needs and requirements. However, if you're starting, I would highly recommend concentrating on one cloud provider first. The major cloud providers include Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud Platform. AWS is the largest and most widely used cloud platform, with a wide range of services and capabilities. Azure is Amazon's biggest contender and well known for the Azure Active Directory and the natural integration in Microsoft Office 365 products and services. Google Cloud has actually been the first cloud provider on the market, but industry adoption is way behind Amazon and Microsoft as of now. So ideally, start with either AWS or Azure. Especially for AWS, exist a variety of free and paid learning resources and plenty of job opportunities. GCP is also great, and I like the UX, but in terms of adoption, it lags behind Amazon and Microsoft. And don't waste your time learning IBM or Oracle Cloud if you're not guaranteed to work with one of them. As a cloud engineer, it is important to understand at least one programming or scripting language, especially for automating tasks and provisioning resources in the cloud. I recommend going with Python or JavaScript, TypeScript, as they are both versatile and beginner-friendly languages that do well in other disciplines like web development or data science. A very recent trend in the cloud space is called serverless. It means that engineers can concentrate on writing code without worrying about the underlying infrastructure. A very prominent example is functions as a service. These serverless functions, like AWS Lambda, execute their code only when needed, making them way more flexible and scalable than traditional server-based architectures. It is important to note that the specific programming skills required for a cloud engineer may vary depending on the particular tasks and responsibilities of the role. What's mandatory, though, is that you know your way around Git and a product like GitHub or GitLab. You will have your programming code and infrastructure as code files stored in repositories. Infrastructure as code? On to the next part, DevOps. DevOps is a set of practices that aims to improve collaboration between development and operations teams and increase software delivery speed and reliability. As a cloud engineer, it is vital to understand DevOps principles and how they can be applied in a cloud environment. Here are specific areas of DevOps that a cloud engineer should be familiar with. Continuous integration and delivery is the practice of automating the build, test, and deployment of software. In a cloud environment, this can involve using and configuring tools like Jenkins, Travis CI, or Circle CI to automate the deployment of code changes to cloud-based resources. Infrastructure as code means using code to define and provision cloud infrastructure and services. A cloud engineer will typically spend a lot of time writing YAML files for tools and services like HashiCorp Terraform, AWS CloudFormation, or Azure Resource Manager. In the last few years, frameworks like AWS Cloud Development Kit or Pulumi set out to enable engineers to define cloud infrastructure and applications using their favorite programming languages. An essential aspect of DevOps is the ability to monitor and log the performance and usage of applications and infrastructure to identify and troubleshoot issues. As a cloud engineer, you may need to use tools like New Relic, Datadog, Splunk, or cloud provider native solutions to monitor and log the performance of cloud resources. DevOps emphasizes the importance of collaboration and communication between development and operations teams. This can involve using tools like Slack, Jira, or GitHub in a cloud environment to facilitate communication and collaboration among team members. Seeking opportunities to gain practical, hands-on experience with cloud technologies is essential to becoming a successful cloud engineer. And the first step is to create an account with one of the big cloud providers, AWS, Azure, or GCP. Each platform offers generous free tiers to get you started with their services. However, I think the AWS free tier is the most comprehensive one, so if you're in doubt, go for that. You'll probably need a credit card to sign up. Always check if the service you want to try is eligible for the free tier. And never forget to shut down your resources when you're finished. Here are some mostly free resources I found to be very helpful. Amazon offers two comprehensive collections of hands-on workshops created by experts and that you can take for free to gain practical experience with the AWS services. The first one is available at workshops.aws. I recommend courses from the following categories. No worries, I will list the categories mentioned in this video's description. More courses are available, so have a look around. The second collection can be found at awsworkshop.io. To become a cloud engineer, I recommend the following categories. Another great learning resource in the AWS universe is the Skill Builder program. It offers various courses that you can take for free. And not only that, many courses provide digital badges upon completion that you can add to your resume, demonstrating your knowledge of particular AWS services. And it's pretty entertaining to complete all the challenges. I recommend looking at things that correlate with the courses from above, like DevOps, databases, EC2, etc. Microsoft provides excellent learning resources for its services. You can choose from various learning paths that you can take for free, depending on your experience and goals. And these learning paths are a great way to prepare for certification exams. For a cloud engineer role, I suggest filtering for the following roles to find good modules to take. Microsoft offers free, in-depth virtual training events that you can register for. It is a great learning resource, and occasionally Microsoft will hand out free certification vouchers as well. Look for events that complement the categories from above, like DevOps. Sadly, Google doesn't offer something similar to AWS and Azure. They have their own learning platform called Google Cloud Skills Boost, where you can find many hands-on labs, but most of them are not for free. Sometimes Google runs challenges and offers vouchers for free credits. So you might want to be on the lookout for these. If you know of such a giveaway, let us know in the comments. Here are two links that can be helpful in learning GCP. And don't worry, I'm working on a GCP course for beginners. Compared to web development, gaining hands-on experience as an aspiring cloud engineer without a job is harder. You can pick a code editor or IDE and start programming. You'll probably have a working web application ready in a few hours. Setting up cloud infrastructure is more complex, and it's hard to showcase in many cases. Furthermore, cloud technologies are often more complex and require a deeper understanding of distributed systems, networking, and security concepts. There is also great demand for experienced cloud engineers, which means entry-level positions and internships may be more competitive. Obtaining a certification can be beneficial for several reasons. Validation of skills. A certification demonstrates to potential employers that you have specific knowledge and skills in a particular area. This can be especially important for cloud engineering, as the field is constantly evolving and it can be difficult for employers to determine the level of expertise of job candidates. Improve job prospects. A certification can make you a more competitive candidate for job openings and may increase your chances of getting hired. Professional development. Obtaining a certification can help you stay up to date with the latest technologies and best practices, which can be valuable for your professional development and long-term career growth. Increased earning potential. In some cases, certifications may lead to higher salaries or better job opportunities, as employers may be willing to pay a premium for employees with specific certifications. At least for me, it's always fun to challenge myself by acquiring new certificates. Here are the most valuable certificates for cloud engineers, in my opinion. I highly recommend the AWS Associate certificates, as they are widely recognized in the industry, cover many important topics, and will increase your market worth. As a cloud engineer, all three are valuable to you. The professional certificates are relevant if you have some experience and are already working in a cloud engineer role. The same goes for the specialty certs. Skip the AWS Cloud Practitioner because it's too essential for what you need to do in a job. Azure certifications are also valuable and good to have. Start with either AZ-104 or AZ-204. You can later attempt the AZ-700 and the AZ-500. With some years in the job, aim for expert level certifications like AZ-305 and AZ-400. For Google Cloud, the Associate Cloud Engineer is the best certification to start with. As Google says, someone holding that cert can deploy applications, monitor operations of multiple projects, and maintain enterprise solutions to ensure that they meet target performance metrics. This is pretty much what a cloud engineer does day to day. As with AWS or Azure, if you have some years of experience, try to obtain the PCA, PCD, PCDOE, and other professional level certifications. It is important to note that while a certification can be beneficial, it is not always necessary to have one to get a job as a cloud engineer. It may depend on the specific job requirements and your experience and skills in the field. To become a successful cloud engineer, you need to have a mindset focused on delivering scalable, reliable, and secure solutions. If you have something to add from your experience, share it in the comments. This was How to Become a Cloud Engineer. Subscribe to the channel for more career advice and tech knowledge.